Hi everybody, this is Maya Newman. I am a clinical instructor in PD, and what I would like to do is share the way that I believe students learn well from the sloppy copy. Now, understand that there are multiple different ways to do this, and yes, there is much more pedagogical way to do it. I am just gonna do something fun that we do at the beginning of clinical, and I like my students to walk through the patient and have a good idea of what their plan's gonna be before they see the patient. So when they get report, they'll come to us and they'll sit down and we'll say, okay, so I have a 2-year-old patient with COVID, okay? And so knowing that I have a 2-year-old patient with COVID, I have to think about what my priorities are, okay? And so I'm definitely thinking we've got respiratory without a doubt, right? So we've got respiratory. Excuse my spelling. We also have, where it's a 2-year-old, we're gonna have safety, absolutely, right? So we've always got safety. And I tell everybody that one of the things that there is there are always three parts of the concept map, okay? And that would be number one is safety. So every patient, we're worried about safety. So we wanna make sure the side rails are up. We wanna make sure there's no choking hazards, that there's no falls risks. And if the baby, it's a baby, we'd worry about things being in the way that the mom could trip on, right? And with a crib, we wanna make sure both side rails are up at the top and that the top has come down so that those kids can't fall. I'll often tell them their heads are big and all they have to do is look over the edge and they can fall out. So we need to make sure those rails are safe. We look for IV tubing. We will look for any heart monitors, make sure that they're not being pulled around. And so I'll tell them that these are things they need to look at the whole time. Okay, so we need to look at safety. And then we also do a nosy check. And so I'll tell them a little bit about the nosy check and we'll go through that in a little bit. And then, so they always have safety. They're always, always, always gonna have anxiety. And who has anxiety when there's a 2-year-old? Well, we might have some stranger danger, right? Stranger anxiety. And we wanna make sure that the parents are safe and that there's no history of domestic violence or abuse. We wanna make sure that the parents have good education, but that's even going to be another option off the side. And then we're also going to make sure that we use age appropriate behaviors, and both behaviors and interventions, right? And we got to find out from mom, like, are they missing work? Are they, do they have other children? You know, what kind of things does a child like? The child likes. And then what kind of things is mom gonna be able to help with? And keep mom or dad or provider, we wanna keep them very involved in the care, right? And then we're gonna look at education, right? So what do they know? What do they need to know? We're gonna constantly be kind of like self-talk and explaining. We're also going to provide written material, new meds, written material, and of course, discharge instructions, right? So as you can see, this is definitely sloppy. But that's okay, because we're getting a good idea of what we're gonna do, right? So we've got safety, anxiety, and education are always guaranteed, okay? And then we have the things that are much more particular to the patient. And so in that, we have respiratory, right? And so as respiratory, in our location, we're required to do 2-hour respiratory assessments, okay? And that consists of, are there retractions? any accessory muscle use? Is there any shortness of breath? How's their color? We're gonna do respiratory rate, right? We're gonna do work of breath. Are they on O2? Do they need O2? And what is the chain of command for O2? And so we all know in my facility, right, we have multiple different things, but we start with either blow by, and with a 2-year-old, it would probably be blow by. And then we would go to nasal cannula. We would do a simple face mask. Then we would do a non-rebreather. And we could do positive flow, which is a great new invention that seems to be keeping kids out of the ICU. And then if these aren't working, we're going to be looking at an Ambu bag or even, you know, ventilation, right? We're going to need vent assistance. So those are how we escalate the oxygen. So that all goes over here. Okay, so then while we're looking at respiratory, we're going to find out, are there any NEBs? Any steroids? Any meds? NEBs and meds. Things like that we're looking at. Okay, and then from there, we're going to look at, so we've got respiratory, we also are going to look at infection, right? And so infection, because it's COVID positive precautions, right? So we're going to need gown, gloves, mask, right? And we're going to need to know temp. How about any labs? We're going to be looking at white counts or cultures. Cultures. We're going to be looking at the spread and is anybody else infected? And then we are also going to make sure we've got precautions in place. We're going to make sure they watch the spread. We're going to be looking at any colored mucus or any other concerns in regard to infection. And obviously if there's been a chest x-ray, we'll see if there's any sign of pneumonia, okay? And then the other things we might be looking at too, depending on the situation, would be cardiac, right? And that we're watching the blood pressure. Some of this would be either cardiac or it could even be under dehydration. Because with dehydration, we're going to be looking at heart rate. We're going to be looking at skin turgor, INOs, weight. We're going to be looking at all of these little things to make sure that the kids offer things that they like, child likes, child preferences. We want to measure. We want to do INOs in the bathroom. Diapers, we're going to be weighing them. So we're going to be watching to make sure that that kiddo is hydrated well. And if they have an IV, right, we're also going to look at the IV site for infection. But we're going to be looking at, is it the right rate, the right dose, the right calculations, and things like that. And back to infection, we're going to be looking at antibiotics. Let's see if there's any there. So I don't know if you get the picture, but basically what we're doing is we're looking at the patient and what do you need to know about that patient for your shift and what kind of things are going to be important to you to make sure that you assess. And what this does is a couple of things. It helps the students to know what they need to bring in with them, right? Because you need to get your blood pressure, you need a thermometer, you may need to change the bed, you may need more diapers, things like that. So it helps them to be prepared. But it also gives them a way to like visualize the plan in place, as opposed to kind of a cut and paste, very traditional typed model nursing care plan. This is effective because they do it before they see the patient and they're modifying it as they're seeing the patient. So by the end of the day, when they have to go put this into a formal concept plan, then they already have most of the information done and so they feel much more successful. And then they can say, okay, well, I was concerned the priority was respiratory, right? We gave two nebs, the patient had some steroids, the oxygenation was, you know, 95% on room air, was patient was able to tolerate walking, was able to tolerate a nap, and they're ready to go home. And so that's how you can justify how we use this concept map. So I hope this helps you help the students to get started on a sloppy copy, okay? It's not formal, it's much more casual, like, and it is sloppy, but it, you know, if you have the right student who's very clear and nice little boxes, that's fine, but you can also like sloppy it out. And that's okay too, because number one, most important thing is that you're learning something from this patient. And by doing it this way, you're looking at your priorities, you're looking at your interventions, and you're evaluating the whole patient so that you're not forgetting the dehydration just because you're focused on respiratory, right? We're always looking at anxiety, we're looking at safety. And stay tuned, because I'm gonna do a video on NOSY, and I think you'll understand how I do safety checks with my students. But it's a little non-traditional, a little bit more casual than we're used to, but I think that students really respond well to something that you're passionate about rather than a cut and paste paper document. Thank you.